Welcome to Mechanical Classroom. Today we are going to discuss 6th part of Module 4 of the subject Engineering Mechanics of Kerala Technological University. Today we are going to discuss about two important principles, that is impulse momentum principle and work energy principle. First one is impulse momentum principle. It is otherwise known as impulse momentum equation. According to impulse momentum equation, impulse of force equal to final momentum minus initial momentum. Now let's derive this equation, that is impulse of force equal to final momentum minus initial momentum. This is basically derived from Newton's second law, which we know net force is equal to mass into acceleration. Acceleration can be written as dv by dt. Rearranging the terms and integrating between the limits, we'll be getting integral t1 to t2 f into dt equal to m into integral v1 to v2 dv. We'll be getting this equation, integral t1 to t2 equal to f into dt equal to mv2 minus mv1. That is impulse of force. F into dt is nothing but impulse of force, which is equal to final momentum minus initial momentum. This is final momentum and this is initial momentum. This equation is referred to as principle of linear impulse and momentum. This is a very useful equation in dynamics. If we don't know the final velocity and we have given with force, time, initial velocity and mass, we can find out final velocity. Now, in order to illustrate this principle, let's do a problem. A ball of mass 50 gram hits the ground with a speed of 4 meter per second and rebounds with an initial speed of 3 meter per second. If the ball is in contact with the ground for 0.01 second, find the average force exerted on the ball. Let's see what all data are given. Here mass m equal to 50 gram is given. This is actually initial speed 4 meter per second, and this is the speed after rebound, that is final speed 3 meter per second. The ball is in contact with ground for 0.01 second, means time is given. So according to impulse momentum equation, we have f into t equal to mass into final velocity minus mass into initial velocity. You can see in this figure, this is the initial velocity and this is the final velocity after rebound. And here it is shown that upward direction is taken as positive direction. Now we are applying the given values, we'll be getting force as 35 newton. This 35 is positive, which means force is upward. So the ground exerts an average upward force of 35 newton. So this is all about impulse momentum equation or impulse momentum principle. Now let's see another equation, work energy equation, which is otherwise known as work energy principle. So we can state work energy equation or work energy principle as the work done by all forces acting on a particle equals the change in the kinetic energy of the particle. Now let's derive this equation. This equation also is evolved from Newton's second law. Consider a particle of mass m as it moves from position 1 to position 2 along the path, with its path coordinate changes from s1 to s2. Applying Newton's second law in the direction of tangent to the path, sigma ft equal to m into a into t, where t stands for a direction of tangent. So also we know acceleration along tangent is v dv by ds. We are substituting to this equation, we will be getting sigma ft into ds equal to mv into dv. Integrate this equation along the paths, we will be getting this expression, and the result of the integration will be u12 equal to half m into e2 square minus v1. will be equal to half into m into v2 square minus v1 square. This equation is known as work energy principle, or it is otherwise known as balance of work and kinetic energy. So work done by the resultant force acting on a particle equal to change in kinetic energy of the particle. That is what we can see from this equation. Work done by the resultant force, that is u12, equal to half into m into v2 square minus v1 square, that is change in kinetic energy. This is otherwise known as work energy method. Okay, now let's do a simple problem in order to illustrate work energy equation. A sludge of total mass 30 kg initially moving at 2 meter per second is pulled 40 meter across smooth horizontal ice by a horizontal rope in which there is a constant tension of 45 newton. Find its final velocity. Now let's draw the diagram according to the given data. We have a sludge whose mass is given as 30 kilogram, and its initial velocity is 2 meter per second, and it is pulled 14 meter it is pulled, so 40 meter, this is final velocity. This 45 is the resultant force on the sludge. So we have expressed everything given in the problem in the figure. Now let's do the problem. Since the ice is smooth, the work done by the force is all converted into kinetic energy, and the final velocity can be formed using work energy principle, which we have already discussed. According to work energy principle, work done by the force equal to final kinetic energy minus initial kinetic energy. Applying to this equation, 45 into 40 equal to half into 30 into v square minus half into 30 into 2 square, v is the final velocity. We'll be getting final velocity as 6.8 meter per second. Hope you understood the two important principles in the dynamics, that is impulse momentum equation and work energy equation. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe and share my channel. I can be Russell.